There are numerous names for this large freshwater basin, which is about 21 kilometers long, 12 kilometers wide, and 200 meters below sea level. But in all languages and all over the world, it is known as the Lake of Jesus. Countless are the biblical quotations of the event that took place on its shores. For the Jewish people, explained Brother Massimo Luca, professor of the Studium Biblicum Franciscanum in Jerusalem, it is Yam Kinneret. Yam means lake or sea, because in the Hebrew language the term is the same, while Kinneret means harp, which is similar in form. The lake is also referred to as Lake or Sea of Galilee, from the name of the region it borders with, while in John's Gospel it is called Lake of Tiberias, from the name of the city which already existed. Finally, it is also known as Lake of Gennesareth, a Greek name derived from Ginnosar, which in Hebrew means the adjacent plain.
Ecco, Gesù, i Vangeli ci dicono che lasciata a Nazareth si ritirò, cioè venne a vivere, ad abitare a Cafarno, al punto che ne...
The Gospel tells us that when Jesus left Nazareth, he came to live in Capernaum, to the point that in the Gospels it acquired the title of the City of Jesus. Here, next to Capernaum in the hinterland, there was an important road of communication, the Via Maris, a road popular with travellers in general. Moreover, Capernaum had another peculiarity. It was a border town. This way, Jesus' message could be spread much more widely because the travellers reported the presence of an extraordinary man who worked in Capernaum.
Riferivano della presenza di un uomo straordinario che operava in Cafarno. Due anni fa, o poco più, avevamo sfiorato proprio il default.
2 years ago, we came close to the flooding of the lake, which means that the level was lower than the Jewish scientists or experts called minimum water level to safeguard the ecosystem. We were below 312 meters below sea level. But in the last 2 years, thanks to the rainfall of the last 2 winters in which the rain was heavy, the lake has returned to these levels. The last time it reached these levels was in winter 2002-2003, 17 years ago.
La pioggia, ecco, il lago è ritornato dopo 17 anni. Io l'ho visto l'ultima volta nell'inverno 2002-2003 che aveva raggiunto questo livello.
An important reservoir, in the last 70 years the lake has undergone continuous fluctuations. In the 80s and 90s, the lowering of hydrometric levels was due to the increased demand for fresh water due to population growth, climate change, as well as agricultural and industrial development. And today there is the news that the level of the lake has risen to 13 centimeters below the upper red line of 208.80 meters below sea level. Once this threshold is exceeded, there is a risk of flooding.
Stiamo qui di fronte al lago di Galilea, lago che è molto suggestivo per i primi cristiani.
We are in front of the Lake of Galilee, very suggestive for Jesus, for the first Christians, but also for all those pilgrims who come here every year. It is the only place, in fact, where pilgrims can touch the waters of the Lake of Galilee and experience a very strong moment. In September, people had to walk a lot to touch the water.
A settembre, gente doveva camminare tanto per arrivare all'acqua e per toccarla. Allora ci è rimasto solo, come diceva.
The only thing left is, as the pilgrim Egeria used to say, on the right side of the church, the stairs that were covered with water.
Erano coperte dell'acqua.
The same hydrometric levels that Pope Paul VI, the first pope to visit the Holy Land, could see in 1964. From the steps of the Church of the Primacy, the successor of Peter was able to touch the water, and the photographers captured the extraordinary event.